2 because that video was getting way too long and my phone storage was about to delete the video because whenever a video gets too long, it deletes the video. So, let me just be pointless busy work, Ida muttered. She hoped that Luz wasn't inside, wasting her time. Is it zooming in? What the heck? Sorry, people. Wasting her time. But her honor, Ida saw Luz sitting next to a classroom. No! Ida cried. Gus and Willow sat. Wait, hold on. No! Ida cried. Ba-da-ba-boom! Gus and Willow sat at their table in the cafeteria, the abomination vault beside them. Do humans eat PB&Js? Gus asked. Oh my gosh, I haven't eaten real food in so long. Please give me some, Luz spluttered. Gus happily split his sandwich into two and handed Luz inside the vault. Willow warned them to be careful so Amity wouldn't see. As on cue, Amity jumped onto their table and shouted, I saw that! Abominations don't eat! She yelled into the vault. I know you're in there! You can't hide from me! What are you? Who are you? I want answers! Amity pulled Luz from the vault and shook her. Suddenly, the abomination teacher walked into the cafeteria. Amity Blight! I suspected a twitch of jealousy, but this is just sad. But I know, look at it, Amity said, holding Luz by her shirt collar. But Luz was standing in the vault, looking all abominably, moaning, report to principal's bump office, the abomination teacher ordered. But now, the teacher thundered. Amity ran off with a scowl on her face, and Luz and Willow looked on worried.
We will be back on Disney Channel.
Chapter 5.
We are back on Disney Channel.
So, did you find your running away student? King asked as Ida emerged from the forest. He was still busy training Prince Doctor, or at least trying to biscuit after, wait, at least trying, but King's idea of training announced to the tossing dog biscuit after dog biscuit into a creature. Who had now grown twice Ida's height? When Ida only glared at King, he said, by your expression, I can tell Luz has gone, found herself someplace else to learn. Which means I have won. Yes, great, you won, Ida said emotionless. You have a great soldier thing, and I have nothing. Congrats. Oh, Ida, don't say that, King replied.
At least you have this.
King handed her a conch call that said shame on it and laughed. Ida grabbed the hat and stormed off into a shack, attached into the owl house. Here, let me move because my legs are dying. I'm going to hold the book like this instead. Where were we? Hold on. Ida grabbed the hat and stormed up to the shack attached to the owl house and slammed the door. I'm so funny, King announced. Well, Prince Jr., training complete. Go forth. Make a world temper at your feather worm stumps. Wait, I said that wrong. At your feet, worm stubs. Unsurprisingly, Prince Jr. didn't know as move go forth. Go forth? King asked. Prince Jr. didn't... Still did nothing. King shook the box of dog biscuits, but there was nothing left. Prince Jr. started to growl. Dun, dun, dun. After lunch, Gut, Willow, Gus, and Luz, new to the Abomination 101 classroom, the top of the vault came off, and Luz emerged stretching. Woo! I'm a sweaty little Abomination, she said. But now, we don't have to worry about Amity. High five! Luz held up a hand, palm outward, but Gus and Willow just stared at her. Slap my hand, Luz inserted. I'm a human. It's a human thing. Oh, Gus said as he struck Luz's hand over and over again. Oh man. What a rush. Suddenly, the classroom door swung open. Ow. Amity stood in the doorway, smiling with Principal Bump behind her. Good morning, students, the principal said. Principal Bump! Willow exclaimed. Luz quickly went into her Abomination root and fell on the floor. The principal walked towards Luz and grabbed her jaw, moving her head around, and stared at Luz. Gwen took a step back. Abomination, rise, he ordered, on command. Luz stood up. Abomination, the principal said, lie. Thinking fast, Luz said, the viral fame is worthy, Pursuit. Your cat would never eat you if you got the chance. Chinchas are... The principal broke out laughing. Oh no, Abomination. How strange for it. Get the command wrong. I mean, lie down. He pointed toward the table. Luz grunted and shamped toward the table and lay down. So very like, Principal Bump said to Willow. When lifelike, my fault. So very lifelike, Principal Bump said to Willow. When Miss Blight told me about your Abomination, I had to come by and see what she's made of. I have the list of her ingredients right here, Willow said, digging into her pocket. No, the principal replied as he pulled out something gleaming like a knife. We are hoping for a closer look, he said. Then he handed a knife to Willow as Amity smirked. Willow, I'll allow you the first cut. A panic Willow leaned into Luz, whispering, you can't just cut open a human, can you? Luz's eyes were huge and her head shook her hand. Oh, and she shook her head. Then Gus shouted, wait, Principal Bump. Wait, Principal Bump! Everyone turned and looked at Gus.